Well, I spoke to the county manager in charge of all of this, and he says they have heard from tons of worried people who are worried that if oil were to come ashore, that this plan includes putting boom across the inlets, all of the inlets in the county, and blocking portions of the intracoastal boat traffic. However, he wants to assure everyone that this would happen only in the very worst case scenario. The county has finished its month-long plan on how to react to oil coming here. While there are red lines indicating boom closing off portions of the intracoastal, that's only if active heavy oil were coming ashore. In the case, as they expect, of simple tar balls and weathered oil, the county would only put booms parallel to sensitive areas.
Everybody had the same concern about locking the inlets, but that's why we wanted to explain that that's a worst-case scenario. We have to be able to plan for the worst or the best. And that's why we've, and part of this booming strategy is that we have prioritized the booming.
So again, no boom unless across the inlet and the intracoastal, unless the oil were actually washing ashore here and then it was threatening to go inside the intracoastal. Otherwise, they would just put parallel boom on that sensitive seagrass. And they also say even if they did have to close off portion of the intracoastal, they might be able to move the boom aside on the outgoing tide. But as Dan Bates points out, if the oil were that bad in the intracoastal or just offshore here, no one would want to be fishing, diving, or boating anyway. Live in Juneau Beach, Terry Parker, WPBF 25 News.